There you go. Well, once again, welcome everyone. And Yolanda and I yesterday went down to Vero to see a wonderful movie that I suggest that everyone takes the time to go see, because it really helped me pull myself away from the work and the things that I've been entrenched in now for a while. Here in the teachings, as we're getting ready to launch into a new adventure next year. And the movie was about Christmas, and it was the story of Charles Dickens, and it was called The Man Who Invented Christmas. And if you haven't seen it, just definitely take the time to see it, because it's just a wonderful story. And it speaks about the symbolism and the metaphor of that amazing story and the Christmas Carol, A Christmas Carol, and what it's really about, because it's the story of his life. And the cinema work, the camera work, the characters and their casting and the development of the movie was just extraordinary. And I thought it was just a wonderful experience for me. It really helped lift me up out of the doldrums of administrations and the things that I've been immersed in here to just a much nicer place, to remember to celebrate life, to celebrate our time. So, once again, welcome and Merry Christmas. And it is Christmas. You know, it's not just holidays, it's Christmas. And I'm very much in favor of just calling it Christmas. You know, we've been through all the different social dramas and political dramas of what to call the holiday, and it's Christmas. So that's what we're calling it. And tonight's teaching, as it is the story of Twas the Night Before Christmas, just this wonderful little story, is not about the history of Christmas. It's not about any of the facts around it. It's not about the story of the life of Jesus, any of that, because those are all kind of cursory ideas that are brought into what Christmas is about. Christmas is a spirit. It's the Christ Mass. Mass meaning celebration. Christ meaning a presence or a consciousness that dwells within each one of us. It's about a celebration of this consciousness, of this presence. And while many people, as they begin to explore consciousness and alternative ways of looking at things, they reject the tradition of Christmas. They reject the idea of what Christmas is all about. And to me, that's like throwing the baby out with the bathwater. In that it's not as much a religious event as it is a celebration of a true spiritual event, which is the awakening, the birth of that beautiful innocence within each one of us that is the essence of what the spiritual journey is all about. So, without me rambling too much further, let's just step into this. And don't worry about me wearing my glasses. I only need them if I need to understand what it is I'm trying to read. So, "'Twas the night before Christmas," went all through the house. "Not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. The stockings were hung by the chimney with care, in hopes that St. Nicholas would soon be there. The children were all nestled, all snug in their beds, while visions of sugar plums danced in their heads. And Mama in her kerchief and I in my cap had just settled down for a long winter's nap. When out on the lawn there arose such a clatter, I sprang from the bed to see what was the matter. Away to the window I flew like a sash or flash, tore open the shutters and threw up the sash. The moon on the breast of the new-fallen snow gave luster of midday to objects below. When what to my wondering eyes should appear but a miniature sleigh and 8 tiny reindeer. With a little old driver so lively and quick, I knew in a moment it must be St. Nick. More rapid than eagles his coursers they came, and he whistled and shouted and called them by name. Now Dasher, now Dancer, now Prancer, now Vixen, on Comet, on Cupid, on Donder and Blitzen, to the top of the porch, to the top of the wall, now dash away, dash away, dash away all. As the dry leaves that before the wild hurricane fly, when they meet with an obstacle mount to the sky, so up to the housetop the coursers they flew, with a sleigh full of toys and St. Nicholas, too. And then in a twinkling I heard on the roof the prancing and pawing of each little hoof. As I drew in my head and was turning around, down the chimney St. Nicholas came with a bound. He was dressed all in fur from his head to his foot, and his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and soot. A bundle of toys he had flung on his back, and he looked like a peddler just opening his pack. His eyes, how they twinkled, his dimples, how merry, his cheeks were like roses, his nose like a cherry. His droll little mouth was drawn up like a bow, and the beard of his chin was as white as the snow. The stump of his pipe he held tight in his teeth, and the smoke, it encircled his head like a wreath. He had a broad face and a little round belly that shook when he laughed like a bowl full of jelly. He was chubby and plump, a right jolly old elf, and I laughed when I saw him in spite of myself. A wink of his eye, a twist of his head, soon gave me to know that I had nothing to dread. He spoke not a word, but went straight to his work and filled all the stockings, then turned with a jerk, and laying his finger aside of his nose, and giving up a nod, up the chimney he arose. He sprang to his sleigh, to his team gave a whistle, and they all flew like down on a thistle. But I heard him exclaim as he drove out of sight, Merry Christmas to all, and to all a good night. A Merry Christmas to all, and to all a good night. For all of my grandchildren, all 9 of them, my 3 glorious girls, wonderful women that they are, for my wife, who is just the jewel in my life. I am so thankful. And that's really what Christmas is all about, is taking time outside of the rhythms of the busyness in our lives to remind ourselves to be present with what's truly important. We all have so much to be grateful for, so much to be thankful for. So as we take this week in preparation for the Christ Mass, you know, the celebration of the Christ, let's remind ourselves of that child, that newborn within each one of us that is innocent and wide open to the limitless possibilities of life. This child within each one of us that looks into the open book without prejudice, without fear, without expectations and conditions, filled with a sense of curiosity, the eagerness of discovery. And just a sense of gratitude for the simplest of things. This is really what Christmas is about. So, and as we wind up my 29th year of lecturing and teaching, we complete one great cycle, another great cycle. For me, it completes my second Saturn return. I'm 59. I'll be 60 in March. And it completes the Saturn return for these teachings, the Order of the Blue Star. And we move into a new chapter together. All of us do. As the world rediscovers and reinvents itself, as we emerge into the next great adventure for humanity, I think that this Christmas, I know that this Christmas is very important. And that as we can take time away again from the busyness that life demands of each of us, and just remember how important it is to be grateful for this day, to be thankful for the amazing opportunity to even exist. And finally, for me, I remember so many wonderful Christmas year after year with my mom and my dad as a little boy. I remember just the magic, because we were never particularly religious people. My father's religion was his family. And my mother's religion was love and patience. But I remember just the excitement of what Christmas was all about. Just being together and opening just a few simple gifts. And I can remember that feeling, the simplicity, the completeness, the appreciation, the gratitude, just from being. So once again, I want to thank all of you for taking the time and the trouble to be here. It's so nice to see so many of you here so close to the Christmas holiday. And we won't have a class next Monday or the Monday afterwards, because next Monday is Christmas Day. And the Monday after that is New Year's Day. But we'll resume the Monday afterwards and explode into 2018. So if I can serve you in any way, let me know. Yolanda and I and the girls will all be right here throughout the holidays. And until next time, have a very Merry Christmas, and have a blessed and Happy New Year, and Baraka Bashad. May the blessings be. Thank you very much.